Here's my theory, and I believe this is the intellectually coherent position, by the way. If you are a decent human being, you should always cheer for the favorite for the following reason. You've got two people in a contest, athletic contest. One is supposed to win, one is not supposed to win. No one expects them to win, right? It's coming down to the wire, and it's unclear which of these two parties are going to end up on top. If the favorite loses, the psychological pain and emotional distress caused by that person will be considerable. It will be devastating. Everyone said you were supposed to win and you lost. If they recover at all, it'll be a miracle, right? The underdog, on the other hand, no one ever expected them to win. So if they don't win, how upset are they? Not that upset. No one, right? So if you're truly, what is empathy? Empathy is the desire, is the willingness and ability to place your heart in the place of someone else's heart, to feel their pain, right? Who's feeling pain? The favorite, right? If you're at all empathetic, you have to cheer for the favorite. You can't go off this sentimental journey rooting for the person who was never gonna win anyway. I remember as a kid watching Dwight Stones lose to Greg Joy in the 1976 high jump in the Olympics. And I just remember, even though Greg Joy was Canadian, Dwight Stones was the greatest high jumper in like the history of the world up to that point. And he was gonna lose because it was raining. And I could see the distress on his face. And I just thought, I can't take this. I can't take the favorite not winning. It's just too painful. And I've always had that position ever since. So I think all of you should, this is the, and next time you find yourself cheering for the underdog, just check in with your conscience.